Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to make shadows inside of After Effects. So usually we use drop shadow effects to add depth and shadow into our scene, but I think that this method is not so convenient and it doesn't bring us desired result because it looks a bit flat and not so interesting as we would do with effects that I'm going to show you. With this technique you can replace standard drop shadow effect with a new one, and I think it's gonna be fun. If you guys ready, don't forget to hit the like button and let's hop inside of After Effects and let's get started. So I am in After Effects and I have this pre-made scene from Cinema 4D, this 3D render of balloons, and now I'm gonna show you how to add shadow into this scene and how to make it more interesting than you always do. Usually people would go with the drop shadow effect, apply drop shadow, increase the distance and increase softness. And like, it's not so bad, it's much better than without shadows. It has some depth now, but it's not so interesting that it can be. And if we do this in Cinema 4D, the shadows will be much, much more interesting and more realistic. And I'm gonna show you how to do this. So first of all, we need to delete drop shadow and let's start with adding different effects. I'm gonna start with transform. Next one, we need to add fill. Let's change color from red to something. We can use black, but in this case, I prefer to use some really, really dark red, like this, for example. It's gonna be color of our shadows. Then I need to apply effect fast blur. Let's increase softness of our shadows to 3, for example. And the next effect that I want to apply is CC radial blur. And in type, I prefer to use straight zoom, but you can play with fading zoom or center zoom. Let's go with straight zoom. And we need to change center of this effect. It's like count this as a sun source or light source, where your main light source comes from, and we need to increase the amount like this. And the last effect that I want to apply is CC composite. With CC composite we can bring back our original texture, original color. So I'm gonna use in front, and we need to uncheck RGB only. Right, and right now we have some shadows and we can control distance from our object to the source where the shadow will be applied by transform. So we can change position, for example, like this. And also we can control softness of the shadows and we can control the opacity of our shadows by reducing the opacity here in transform panel. For example, 25. And as you can see, right now shadows are way more interesting than it was with the drop shadow effect. It looks more realistic, like in real life shadows. And we can play with those settings to achieve desired result. We can make our shadow more soft, for example, or we can change color to make it more reddish, for example, because everything is red in this scene. That's why I think like it should be more reddish. So basically this is the main idea of this setup. And what's cool about this setup is that I can select all my effects in balloon layer, and I can go to animation, save animation preset, and save this as animation preset, and you can use in all other projects, all other scenes, and it has some quick adjustments. You can change color, you can change softness, play with blur, and that's it. As you can see, we've made really great shadows, and also we can save this as a preset and use in future projects, and everything works fine. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you think about this technique, and don't forget to hit like button and subscribe to my channel. See you guys in the next video. Peace.